SpaceX boss Elon Musk has teased the Starship spacecraft is nearing its first orbital flight, sparking an online frenzy of excitement from fans. Elon Musk tweeted on September 10th, Tuesday, "Getting ready for flight of orbit-class Starship design." The move on the part of SpaceX comes shortly after its Starhopper spacecraft completed a hover test. In late August, during its test of the Starhopper, it was able to hover 500 feet above the ground at SpaceX's Boca, Chica, Texas facility. The hover lasted a little under a minute. The Starhopper landed back successfully on a landing pad that will be used to test the SpaceX Starship. On September 9th, Monday, the first signs of SpaceX planning for Starship Mark 1's South Texas launch debut appeared in the form of FCC applications, requesting permission to communicate with the rocket prototype during its first flight. This FCC filing came days after word from Business Insider that the Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, was effectively granting SpaceX permission to expand its Boca Chica launch facility for the sake of SpaceX Starship launches. The company also hasn't tried to hide its construction work on the orbit quality vehicle, and Musk has alluded to a September 28th update event that could show off the completed spacecraft. It's poised to launch sometime in October, possibly as soon as the 13th. The FAA application confirms several details about SpaceX's Starship Mark 1's debut, revealing that SpaceX will kick off the test campaign with a running jump from Starhopper's 150-meter flight test handoff. The vehicle will fly more than 2 magnitudes higher than its stubby predecessor, reaching an altitude of 20 kilometers, or 12.5 miles, and plans to land the spacecraft just 100 feet or so from its launch site, on the same landing pad used by Starhopper. It's not a true orbital test then, but it's clearly much closer to SpaceX's goals. In this video, Engineering Today will discuss SpaceX's plans with its Starship rocket. SpaceX preps South Texas launch site for Starship rocket test flight. SpaceX confirms it's almost ready to test its orbital Starship. Let's get into details. SpaceX teams continue to work around the clock to ready Starship Mark 1 for its ambitious flight debut. A new ring segment was stacked on top of the vehicle's tank section several days ago, while locals also spotted the delivery of 1 or 2 new legs and fins built out of riveted steel. SpaceX's Boca Chica team continues to struggle to attach Starship's tip to the rest of its curved nose section, having recently separated the segments for the first time in months. Preliminary welding of SpaceX Starship Mark 1's upper tank dome appears to be complete, and technicians are working to integrate the spacecraft's internal hardware before it can be installed. Meanwhile, a new range of concrete pads have been set and are being outfitted with additional production hardware, likely paving the way for simultaneously Starship Starship or Starship Super Heavy builds in the near future. The document from the Federal Aviation Administration revealed SpaceX's various plans for its Mars colonizing rocket, Starship, and provided an excellent overview of planned upgrades to its Starship launch pad. Retasked from original plans and approvals for an additional Falcon 9 Falcon Heavy launch site, the documents confirmed that the FAA has reevaluated its 2014 Environmental Impact Statement, EIS, and is effectively ready to re-permit SpaceX's Boca Chica facilities in light of its new purpose. The Federal Aviation Administration has decided that no supplemental environmental impact statement to the original 2014 EIS allowing SpaceX to operate at Boca Chica is necessary. The FAA issued its Record of Decision based on the original environmental assessment and environmental impact statement in July 2014, greenlighting SpaceX's development of the launch site. The groundbreaking took place in September 2014 with SpaceX CEO Elon Musk and then-Governor Rick Perry in attendance. At the time, SpaceX said that the Boca Chica site would serve as a commercial spaceport primarily for its Falcon Heavy and Falcon 9 rocket. SpaceX secured authorization from the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers for no more than 12 launches of its Falcon 9 rockets per year, including a maximum of 2 launches of the Falcon Heavy. The first Falcon Heavy launch didn't take place until February 2018, with 2 more occurring in April and June of this year, all launches taking place at Cape Canaveral, Florida. However, through the years, the company's plans for the site changed. Currently, the Boca Chica facility is being used for the construction and launch tests for the SpaceX Starship prototypes. The company pursues rapid development and testing of prototypes for the SpaceX Starship spacecraft. In combination with the massively powerful Super Heavy booster, SpaceX Starship is intended to get humans to Mars in the not-too-distant future, with the ultimate goal of colonizing the planet. Despite changing the function and purpose of the site, the FAA ruled that SpaceX is still operating within its original proposal. The agency reported that the site's safety and environmental impact is still the same. Aside from a reassessment of the launch facility, FAA's document also detailed SpaceX's 3-phase plan for Starship. According to the document, Phase 1 involves carrying tests on ground and fueling systems. Phase 2 is where SpaceX is at right now. It's all about conducting small and medium hops, or launches, for Starhopper, a Starship prototype. For this stage, SpaceX has plans to launch the prototype 150 meters off the ground and eventually increasing it to 3 kilometers. But currently, SpaceX doesn't have public plans for medium hops of 30 centimeters up to 3 kilometers. Musk tweeted on August 28th that the next goal is a 20-kilometer flight of the Mark 1 in October, with an orbital attempt shortly thereafter. Phase 3 would serve as the definitive stage for SpaceX Starship's development. Here, SpaceX intends to launch the rocket 100 kilometers above Earth. Aside from this, the company plans to execute various maneuvers, including flips, re-entries, and landing. According to SpaceX, the various test phases of Starship are necessary for achieving the company's goal of sending a human expedition to Mars. The re-evaluation states that SpaceX anticipates the test program lasting 2 to 3 years, and that the results of Phase 1 and 2 will dictate what happens in Phase 3. The re-evaluation covers only the first 2 phases, since SpaceX currently lacks adequate data for the FAA to analyze the potential environmental impacts of Phase 3, according to the agency. The FAA statement, signed in May of 2019, says that the agency did not have the information necessary to permit Phase 3. Prior to commencing Phase 3, SpaceX will be required to submit data and information to the FAA so the FAA can conduct another environmental review before issuing any new or modified launch licenses or permits to conduct these operations, said the agency. SpaceX working on launch site upgrades reportedly needed to support Phase 2 testing. Although extremely similar to what SpaceX has already built in South Texas, some significant changes are definitely present, and it looks like SpaceX has a busy 4 to 8 weeks of work ahead to complete the necessary modifications, including expanding propellant storage, 2 large walls, and possibly underground routing of critical infrastructure. Ultimately, significant work remains for SpaceX to receive both FAA's experimental launch permits and FCC permission to communicate with the rocket for Starship Mark 1's first flight. Based on the 3 weeks it took the FAA to simply extend Starhopper's existing 25-meter hop permit to 200 meters, eventually cut to 150 meters, it could be quite the uphill battle to jump to a 20-kilometer test flight. While SpaceX is moving quickly to test its Starship, it may not have much choice. SpaceX is clearly under pressure to move forward. The company hopes to launch its first commercial Starship flight in 2021, And that doesn't leave it much time to both complete the spacecraft and prove that it can reliably deliver payloads to orbit. In addition to gearing up for more tests, the company has reportedly been working to pinpoint the exact location where the SpaceX Starship will land the first humans on Mars. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.